Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chonsom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Tuesday, the 25th of August. Rescue operation continues as several feared trapped in building collapse in India's Maharashtra. Locals protest against hydropower projects in Pakistan-administered Kashmir. Entry killed 41 wounded in Taliban truck bomb in Afghanistan. And now for all the details. Rescue operation continued on Tuesday at a building collapse site in India's western Maharashtra state as several were still feared trapped. At least 9 bodies had been recovered till the last reports came in and casualties were likely to increase.
More than 60 people, including a 4-year-old boy, were rescued alive on Tuesday after a 5-story building comprising 47 flats collapsed on Monday evening in the industrial town of Raigad near India's financial capital, Mumbai. Death toll in the tragic incident on Tuesday rose to more than 8 and casualties were likely to increase as many were still fear-trapped till the last reports came in. Local police has registered a case against 5 people in the matter. Meanwhile, Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi expressed grief over the incident, giving assurance of needed assistance at the site of the tragedy.
Pressure bhi lagata hai chalega jo hume jahan space mil raha hai wahan koshish kare pehle locate kar le bilkul usko rule out karte hain ki isme bilkul bhi nahi hoga tabhi debris ko hum heavy machine ki sahayata se hata dein.
The cause of Monday's tragic incident was not clear, but building collapses are common in India, usually due to shoddy construction and disregard of regulations. Every year, heavy downpours during the June to September monsoon season also bring down rain-sodden small and large structures deemed too dangerous to live in.
The Congress Working Committee, India's opposition Congress' top decision-making body on Monday decided that Sonia Gandhi will continue as interim president and effect necessary organizational changes. The CWC meeting had been prompted by a letter from 23 senior party members to Sonia Gandhi that summarized several suggestions to ease out niggling worries facing the party.
After a day-long high-voltage political drama for India's main opposition Congress party, the party's top decision-making body on Monday decided that Sonia Gandhi will continue as the party's interim president and effect necessary organizational changes. The Congress Working Committee also resolved that the process of selecting the new party president and convening an All India Congress Committee session be started at the earliest possible time. Sonia Gandhi, the widow of former Indian Prime Minister Rajiv Gandhi, had offered to resign as interim leader after almost 24 senior figures in a letter called for better decision-making in the party. Her request was rejected by Congress Working Committee, which wants Gandhi and her son Rahul Gandhi to remain in control.
The CWC unanimously requests Srimati Sonia Gandhi to continue to lead the Indian National Congress until such time as circumstances will permit an AICC session to be convened.
Sonia Gandhi took over de facto leadership of the party last year from Rahul. His father, grandmother and great-grandfather were prime ministers of India.
In news from Pakistan, Pakistanis have expressed that life under 2-year tenure of Prime Minister Imran Khan has been immensely difficult as they continue to feel the pinch amid spiraling inflation and ongoing economic crisis in the country with no relief in sight.
As Prime Minister Imran Khan completed 2 years in office this month, Pakistanis have expressed that life under his government's tenure so far has been immensely difficult. In terms of the economy, Pakistan's GDP growth has fallen from 5% in 2018 to just 0.5% in 2020. In January, Pakistan witnessed a 12-year high inflation at 14.6%. Last month, the figure slipped to 10.49%, but continues to run in double digits. The currency also has weakened. Sharjeel Goplani, president of All City Tajir Ittehad, a traders association in Karachi, said, "The government's ill-timed policies have added to the public's hardships amid the rising inflation."
They didn't do homework, so for the people, it was a very difficult time for 2 years. And at this time, the people, what do you know, that the चाहे वो यूटिलिटी के बिल हो, चाहे अजनास के रेट हो, चाहे आप किसी भी चीज सेक्टर में आप चले जाएं, इस वक्त आवाम का जो है दिवालिया निकल चुका है।
Less than a year after assuming power, Imran Khan-led government sought a $6 billion package from the IMF, and in April 2020, it again requested nearly $1.4 billion from the IMF to meet its balance of payments as international loans continue to pile up. The ongoing economic crisis in Pakistan has shattered the people's faith in the government, elected on a pledge to eradicate poverty and create jobs.
Moving on, locals and activists in Pakistan-administered Kashmir held a massive protest and torch rally on Monday night against the proposed construction of dams in the illegally occupied region by Pakistan and China. The protesters accused that Islamabad and Beijing are violating the UN resolutions by occupying rivers in the region.
A massive protest and a torch rally was held in Muzaffarabad city of Pakistan-administered Kashmir on Monday night to oppose the mega dams to be constructed by Chinese firms in the illegally occupied region. The protesters accused that Pakistan and China are violating the UN Security Council resolutions by occupying rivers in the region. Pakistan and China recently signed an agreement for 700 megawatt Azad Patian Hydel Power Project and 1,100 megawatt Kohala Project on the Jhelum River. The protesters highlighted a hydropower project on the Neelam River has already severely affected life and posed a serious environmental concern in Pakistan-administered Kashmir due to diversion of the river.
पाकिस्तान और चीन को किसने हक दिया? किसने हक दिया कि वो हमारे दरियाओं
Activists have long blamed that Pakistan and China have been jointly plundering the natural resources of Pakistan-administered Kashmir and Gilgit-Baltistan in the wake of China-Pakistan economic corridor. The resentment in the occupied territories is high against both Islamabad and Beijing.
Moving on to news from Afghanistan. A car bomb blew up near a military base in Afghanistan's Balkh district early Tuesday morning, killing at least 3 people and injuring over 40 people. Insurgent group Taliban claimed responsibility for the attack.
A car bomb blew up near a military base in the Afghan district of Balkh early Tuesday morning, killing at least 3 people in an attack claimed by Taliban insurgents. According to an Afghan Ministry of Defense statement, 41 other people, including civilians, were wounded in the attack. The attack comes at a time when the United States is encouraging peace talks between the Afghan government and the Taliban, while preparing to withdraw the last U.S. troops to end almost 19 years of war.
که مواد انفجاری بار بوده انفجار کرده در قراولی در نزدیکی قرارگاه کماندوی ما مگر خوشبختانه قبل از رسیدن به قراول و داخل قرارگاه توسط پیرادارای بیدار کماندو شناسایی و بالایش اجراءات صورت گرفته که در نتیجه 6 نفر کماندوی ما زخمی می باشه و یک نفر هم شهید می باشه مگر بیشترین قربانیان از این حمله ملکی ها می باشند که تعداد و آمارشان
A Taliban spokesman in a statement said the rebel group was responsible for the attack, claiming dozens of Afghan commando forces were killed and wounded.
Wildlife officials in Sri Lanka recently rescued a baby elephant trapped in a well. The baby elephant was pulled out of the shallow well and was driven back into the jungle in the north central Malatiwu district using firecrackers. In a separate incident, wildlife officials in central hills of Gampola found a leopard which had died in a snare. This is the third hill leopard to be killed in the same way in the last 3 months. Laying snares to catching wild animals is illegal in Sri Lanka. For the first time since 2012, Lake Development Authorities in Srinagar City of India's Northern Jammu and Kashmir Territory have procured high-tech machines to help in cleaning the iconic Dal Lake. One of the most noteworthy tourist destinations, the Dal Lake attracts a large number of tourists from across the world every year and contributes majorly to the economy of the area.
The iconic Dal Lake is integral to tourism and recreation in India's northern Jammu and Kashmir territory, with houseboats being a major tourist attraction for decades. Over the years, the Dal Lake has deteriorated considerably as thousands of tons of sewage spew into it, feeding weeds and choking the lake and its aquatic life of oxygen. The Jammu and Kashmir Lakes and Waterways Development Authority in Srinagar City have procured high-tech machines to help in cleaning the Dal Lake. With manual cleaning proving to be not enough for the entire lake, high-tech machines have been brought to restore the beauty of the lake.
So these are high-capacity machines, which is a high-capacity dividing machine, two dump barges, one self-propelled barge, dividing machine ke baad jo weed hamare isme dockyard mein aayega isko weed transfer crane humne mangwaya hai.
The move has also been welcomed by locals residents who say the machines will prove beneficial for workers and also help boost the tourism sector.
पहले आप देखेंगे तो अगर मैनुअली जो करते थे वो छोटा सा पोर्शन ही क्लीन होता था तो उसमें बीच में वीड आते रहते थे वहाँ पे तो वो क्लीन नहीं होता था प्रॉपरली मगर ये जो इन्होंने अभी किया है अभी जो जोड़ रहे हैं मशीन्स तो इससे पता चल रहा है कि इसका बहुत बहुत ज़्यादा बेनिफिट होगा यहाँ के लोकल्स को भी और जो यहाँ पर काम कर रहे हैं उनको भी और जो टूरिज़म आएगा यहाँ पर उनको भी बहुत ज़्यादा मतलब अच्छा लगेगा यहाँ पर आना.
The lake acts as an important source for commercial operations in fishing and water plant harvesting.
To celebrate the ongoing 10 days Ganesh festival, devotees in India's western Nagpur city have set up a temporary platform themed as the COVID-19 facility featuring Hindu god Ganesha in a doctor's attire. The Ganesha idol has been installed in the form of a doctor to raise awareness about COVID-19 pandemic.
Devotees in Nagpur city of India's western Maharashtra state, known to host one of the most extravagant festivities during the ongoing 10 days Ganesh festival, installed a statue of Hindu god Ganesha in the form of a doctor to raise awareness about COVID-19 pandemic. Wearing a white coat like of a doctor and armed with a stethoscope, the elephant-headed god has been placed in a pandal or temporary platform in the form of a COVID-19 facility. The Ganesha idol is also accompanied by statues of a policeman and a health worker to give the frontline warriors as much respect as God.
ये तो पूरे विश्व में अशांति फैली हुई है कोरोना की महामारी से बहुत लोग कोरोना बाधित है बहुत लोगों का मृत्यु हो गया है वैसे महाराष्ट्र में भी ज़्यादा तादाद में लोग बढ़ रहे हैं हमने सोचा कि अभी इस बार गणेशोत्सव ऐसा मनाना चाहिए कि ये कोरोना का सावट होने के वजह से अपन क्यों ना अपन ने एक हॉस्पिटल कोरोना केयर हॉस्पिटल बनाया जाए ताकि लोगों को यहाँ पे आने के बाद में कुछ मार्गदर्शन मिले.
Every year during Ganesh festival, huge idols of Lord Ganesha are installed in crowded tents and homes for 10 days. However, this year with the pandemic, there are several restrictions in place to avoid rapid spread of the infection. India currently has 3.1 million confirmed cases of coronavirus with at least 58,390 deaths.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now, our viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/AsiaNewsline and follow us on Twitter at AsiaNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.